You ever work inside of your mouth?
Yeah, I've got like my jawline, like the upper, my upper jaw, like pressed in there.
Yeah, from the inside? You can like grab the muscle on the inside.
Yeah. Yeah, that one's a little bit uncomfortable.
Oh, yeah. It's intense, yeah. But it's so effective to grab the muscle on both sides because like there's nowhere else in the body where you can do that.
Yeah. Just on the top, you mean, like, or where you...
Like, grab inside like this.
Oh, yeah.
And then, like, you pull it down, like, all the way to the edge. It's a great way to get it. I want to get certified in called buccal massage, where they work the inside of your mouth.
Really?
Yes, but I'm not quite ready to do that on people yet.
So. Come on, just start digging your fingers in.
You want to be my guinea pig?
Chris don't care.
Yeah, go for it. Wash your hands first.
I'll let Lola
know.
Yeah. I'm good to go.
There we go. So is that like, it was called like buccal massage?
Yes, buccal.
Okay.
Yes. There's a woman in Las Vegas, or not Las Vegas.
I ain't gone.
Las
sure
Angeles.
Be good every day, but.
Teaches it. And I've like learned it from her briefly.
Can't be having this
just,
right
like,
now.
Her social
time
media
to get ramp it up.
Yeah.
And be letting this inhibit you, you know?
People, yeah. But it, I want to because it's really like transformational. Because
yeah.
Like having jaw pain is just, it puts a damper on your whole life. Just
right.
Smiling and chewing
nice
and just everything.
Yeah.
Just,
yeah.
It feels, there's just like a restriction there, you know?
Oh, for sure.
So and the jaw and
the
hips
go.
Are also
so
closely related.
Now. A lot softer.
So, so it's really important to address both. I mean, the entire body needs
yeah.
to be addressed, but.
Yeah, you fix one and then the issue maybe just gets transferred to another portion of your body.
Yeah,
yeah,
yeah. If the fascia's tight, it's just gonna pull everything towards it.
Yeah. And then, like, I started working on, like, I noticed that my shoulders for the longest time, like, they were, like, kind of forward facing.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I started working on, like, actually strengthening the.
Rear delt?
Yeah. My shoulders like way more into alignment.
Yeah.
But now I'm noticing like my shoulder blades like in their back, like my left side is now hurting.
Oh no.
It's like, it's, I think it's just because, oh, it's actually the right spot now. It's gonna, my
adjust.
Body's gonna readjust to actually having proper posture.
Yeah.
Breathing.
Is your scapula ever like wing scapula? Like sticks out? A lot of people have that when your shoulders are pulled forward.
Oh yeah.
It's like another thing that will happen is the scapula will end up winging out. What were you gonna say, Kevin?
I say breathing with your back too can help, you know, is another drop in the bucket for that stuff in that area, you know?
Like breathing into it?
Yeah, like breathing into
you breathe
your
into your back,
rib cage,
into your
rib cage.
Yep.
Rib cage.
Breathe with your back. Because sometimes it's like muscles and areas and joints are tight. Because you have a lot of joints in your spine, you know? Like you literally, per vertebrae, you have like you have your vertebrae joints, one on top and one on bottom, right? Then you have two joints per rib on each side of the vertebrae.
Oh, yeah.
So
there's a lot going on.
There's a lot of joints in one little area, you know?
Yeah.
And imagine if you held your elbow stiff like all the time, you know? Like imagine if you never move your arm.
That's a good point.
You know, like so in one way, you know, sometimes like that's what happens with the upper back is like we just hold it stiff in our ribs, you know. And so I just always try to preach like thinking of trying to breathe, because then you're moving it, you know. Because if you get good at that and you make it a habit, then you're doing it all day, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And
yeah,
you know, but,
oh, yeah.
Yeah. But I mean, that's just it's not. I'm not saying that's what's wrong. It's just one thing that I, you know.
Something
yeah.
to think about.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'll definitely give that a shot.
Because you can breathe really a lot with your upper back, you know.
Yeah.
I actually see a lot of people like backs like get a lot bigger and like more, expand more when I tell them to do that. But
definitely get that shot. I just thought breathing. Honestly, I never thought about breathing with different parts of you.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. That's the first thing I learned in Buddhist school. Is
yeah.
how to breathe. Step one in
yeah.
life, like the kids in school.
It's amazing how, like, even for, like, mental state as well, like, you just breathe out longer than you breathe in.
Yep,
it's like, it's
yep. It calms your nervous system.
Yeah, it's like, it's hardwired where it's not even you're thinking about something, it's like your body just automatically does it.
Yes, biohack.
Yeah.
it's like a program in the body.
Yeah.
It's like programmed, like in the computer, you know? If you do something, it's like, yeah, when you do that, it's
breathing.
Yep.
Yes.
Your biceps are tight, but that's probably what's going on up here.
Yeah.
Probably your bicep tendon.
Just going up there.
That reminds me of what I was thinking about the other day, where, like, when you are singing, that's also happening, where you're taking a shorter inhale and a super long exhale.
Yeah.
I was thinking, like, that's another activity that's really calming and soothing.
Ask and you shall receive, bud.
Actually, I never thought about that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That's another thing.
And music too, as well.
It's when you feel good.
Yeah.
It's like just sing. Just scream singing by now, so that'll work.
You're gonna feel good when you're done.
Let it all out.
Exactly.
You live in a house by yourself?
It's an apartment.
Oh, an apartment.
Yeah.
Awesome. It's
very, actually, thankfully. It's like cement walls and ceiling floor, so.
Nice. That's how ours was, too. And we lived in downtown Minneapolis.
Yeah.
And you couldn't hear, like, anything ever.
Yeah.
Even, like, the bedroom to the living room was very soundproof.
It's such a nice thing. I'm like, okay, well, I can sometimes hear my neighbors if they're, like, blasting music, like,
yeah.
But it's vibrating.
Yeah, it's more, like, you're hearing the, like, you're feeling the vibration
of
the bass.
But other than that, I'm like, okay, well, I'm not too concerned about people hearing me.
Yes.
Blast my crazy music and it'll be good.
Did your shoulder hurt all the time, or just when you lifted or afterwards?
Just when you guys talk.
We're just babysitting her. I do grow over.
I feel like you have blood in the
end
and starts
getting
season
up. We're almost always babysitting a dog. It's a lot of fun. And it does not feel like work. It's awesome.
So you guys just, she just stayed at your place for an extended period of time, or just during the day?
Yeah, well, I offer both services, but I haven't had anyone do the doggy daycare yet, so we've just had, like, overnight stays. We'll have her for a week total.
Yeah.
We just got done watching a dog for, like, 4 weeks.
Okay.
That was the longest stay I've had. It was so much fun, though.
That's super cool.
He was such a good doggy. He just, the only thing that we had to work with him was that he doesn't like other dogs.
All right.
And you love going to the dog park near our house with them, because it's just this, I don't even know how many acres it is, but it's huge and it's off of a river.
Yeah.
And it's so beautiful and it's so amazing to go there, but he acts like he wants to kill the dogs.
Oh,
well,
really?
Like, I don't think he'd even do anything, but he, like, will just kind of freak out.
Yeah, he's real aggressive.
He's a protector.
Yeah.
Like, that's what I feel like he's trying to do, is protect me, and he just doesn't. Understand he didn't have a lot of exposure to other dogs.
Oh, yeah.
So, but honestly, we made a lot of progress with him when he was with me. Like, I just tried to keep him calm every time another dog was around, and he, by the end of the stay, he didn't really freak out as much at other dogs. So
he's getting even more made up to the experience.
Yes. Just keeping him calm. It's like, you don't need to freak out. It's okay.
Idea. My friends just, like, they just lost their dog, and I think they're, like, kind of hesitant to actually get a new one, but I think doing, like, Rover or something would be a bad idea to kind of to
fill the void.
A little bit of a fix. And,
yes.
Like, yeah.
Exactly. Yeah, I'm not ready yet to get a dog.
Yeah.
So that's kind of the same thing with me. I always grew up with dogs, so not having one just.
Yeah.
They're just such amazing little happy lovers.
It's like they're, I don't know, it's cool. Like, humans are supposed to be around animals, and we're supposed to be around dogs and stuff.
And each other.
Yeah.
In tribe, you know.
Yeah.
Not supposed to be so isolated. But yeah, I mean, dogs and humans have been living together for, I don't even know how long.
Yeah.
Yeah. Really?
Yeah.
Oh, that's awesome.
We were on a farm, and, like, so we had dogs, cats, and we had cow.
Are you,
like,
serious?
Yeah,
you lived my dream. How did you feel to live my dream?
It's fantastic, yeah.
That's so cool.
Yeah, my dad's a huge softie with animals, and like he was, you know, one time walking, it was two times. One time was walking his male around, he's a mailman, mm-hmm. and a baby squirrel fell out of a tree, and he actually brought it home, and we had it for a little while, but it didn't end up living for too long. But he still played with us for like a couple of weeks. But
you got to play with the little.
Yeah, it was like a baby, and it was like we would run up, like would climb up you, and then sit on your shoulder and like your ear.
Did it hurt? Did the little claws hurt?
No, it was like super tiny, so it just climb up your shirt, your pants.
Oh, your clothes, yeah. Not your skin.
Yeah, I didn't dig in.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
My dad is a UPS driver, and he said he delivered to a house one time that had a pet squirrel.
Yeah.
And it climbed up his leg, and he was wearing shorts, and like it really hurt, so that's why I asked.
Oh, yeah.
The little claws just dug in.
Yeah. I don't remember them hurting, but maybe I just remember the good parts.
Yeah. Yeah. Brain is good.
Yeah. It was the same with like a raccoon. We had a baby raccoon for a while, too. Like, we have cats, so like, raccoon's name was Chewbacca because so baby raccoons make this like noise, like kind of,
yeah.
Chewbacca, so we named him that, and we bottle fed him for a little while, but like it was winter time and our cat had kittens at the same time.
Oh wow, that's a lot going on at once.
Yeah, we lived on a farm and they were outdoor cats, so
oh,
they were in the garage, and like the kittens were in the garage, the mom and the dad cat. So we let Chewbacca out there to see like if they would be chill with one another, and as like the kittens were nursing, like Chewbacca went up and started nursing off the cat.
Oh
like,
my god.
Okay, cool.
She's adopted, she
yeah.
like she adopted it pretty much?
Yeah, basically, so it just became a cat that
huge.
Just lived with the cats and grew up with the cats and then ended up getting bigger and bigger, and that was cool, but it grows so much faster than regular cats.
Really?
So it got like...
Their lifespan is shorter, maybe?
Maybe, yeah. I don't know. They just got like almost as big as like the mother cat, and like still wanted to nurse. The cat was like, "Now you're too big. We're not doing this anymore." But yeah, it was cool. My dad like likes to play rough with animals, like fuck with them and like play with them.
Just
stuff.
Like Kevin.
Yeah.
Like to wrestle.
Yeah, exactly.
Yes.
But,
they love it too.
Yeah, it's fun. But Chewbacca had very sharp teeth and claws. So eventually when he got big enough, like we couldn't really play with him anymore because all he wanted to do was wrestle.
Yeah.
And so we had to wear welding gloves to like replay with him. It was like, fuck.
Oh my god.
He was a liability. He would just like flip on his back and just latch all four ways.
Oh
by India.
Gosh. Wow. What an experience. How long did you have Chewbacca?
Like a year and a half, and then like he ended up, he'd go off for a day, come back, go off for a couple of days, go back, and then he ended up just not ever coming back. So
he just decided to go out on his own.
Exactly.
Like I'm ready.
Wild, yeah. I mean, we lived on a farm, like with a bunch of trees and everything. So I just think he was. In his teen years, he needed to go be a rebel, and he went after it.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
That's fun. You want to do it with a bird someday?
Oh, yeah.
Rehabilitate a bird.
That'd be really cool.
Honestly, I'm open to anything, though. Any animal.
Yeah.
Like, I would love to have it. So, like, I think it'd be really cool to have a relationship with a wild animal where it, like, doesn't live with you at all, but
oh, yeah.
It'll come visit you.
Yeah.
I saw this video of this woman who had, like, six different, I think it was magpies.
Yeah.
That came and visited her. It started off with one, and then it brought like its whole tribe. And she would like set up like little amusement parks in her backyard for them. Mm-hmm. Like it was
super cool.
So special.
Are magpies the ones that like? Those aren't the ones that like dive bomb you, are they? It's a different one.
Dive bomb? Like, what do you mean?
I remember seeing videos of, like, kids riding bikes and, like, these birds dive bombing and, like, kind of...
Attacking.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, I don't know. They might. I'm really not sure. They're similar to ravens and crows. Like, they're all
yeah.
the same family. They're super, super smart birds.
So I don't know how smart these things are.
Yes. I feel like every animal is a lot smarter than we give them credit for.
Very true.
Like, I feel like humans base an animal's intelligence off of, like, how willing it is to listen to us and, like, learn from us, but it's, like, is that really an accurate way to measure intelligence?
I don't know. She's like, what is going on? What is this place? When am I going to get a mushroom?
Yeah, I was like, this trap, like, this thing is blocking a lot of blood flow to and from.
Yeah.
Your head.
It's very tight.
Does it feel kind of nervy when I'm in there?
A little bit,
yeah.
I can feel like on the top right side of my head, actually. Mice live a year to 2 years, and she's like at least she's almost two, if not over 2 years. Really?
Like, she is just a tank. I don't
feels
know.
Much lighter.
What's
I
that?
Feel like it's
lighter. It feels much lighter now.
Kind of
hey, isn't that amazing?
Yeah.
Yeah. It was so just locked up and tight and stuck.
I just, I'm careful.
And now it's like a wet noodle, huh?
Them,
yep.
Sometimes, like,
yeah, it's going to feel good.
They'll
man,
eat the food they
want
to eat.
It's a good
know?
Workout.
It's like the remaining stuff they don't like as much.
Kind of feel the pressure
like
back here.
Let them hang
push
out
cold.
That sort of thing.
Yeah.
I read something that said mice that fast live way longer than mice that don't.
Really?
So I try not to overfeed her, so I don't have to do that. So my shoes.
Yeah.
But honestly, she got kind of fat anyway, so I feel like when I had the other mice, she kind of hogged for food.
Yeah.
And she just ended up being kind of sedentary. When we first got her, she loved running on the little wheel, and then after that, she just was like, I like food more, so
yeah.
It's my thing.
I'm gonna sit, be comfortable, and I'm gonna wait it out.
Yes. They have a giant cage, like it's a chinchilla cage.
Oh yeah?
Yes. Because at first they lived in a smaller one, but I just care a lot about animals, so I'm like, if I was a mouse, I would want like a big cage so I could run around in and fly.
Oh yeah.
So I tried to do that for them.
That's really cool.
We had fish for a while too.
Yeah.
Beta fish.
Cool. Let's put it together.
Yes. I had a 10-gallon tank for it though. I had so much room to put it.
That's cool. I just thought it'd be interesting to have like a big aquarium.
Yes.
Pretty awesome.
Yes, I want one so in due time we'll have that.
Yeah, exactly.
Facebook Marketplace is good.
Yeah. Is that right?
Yeah. It's good for like everything, honestly. Facebook Marketplace is good shit.
Yeah.
This side feels to a spider.
Really?
Yeah. Does it feel more tender to you?
Yeah, it's definitely tender.
Yeah.
It's good though. I was in the bathroom and I saw the terrarium with all the dinosaurs and everything.
Yes.
Like, one of those things. I don't think anything I've got on Facebook.
Oh yeah, check it out. Anything you need.
Craigslist. Okay. crazy price Craigslist is still a thing.
I was gonna say, I don't really use Craigslist, I don't know if it's popping on there or not, so...
I haven't changed the website since, I remember it came out, so...
Why don't they, like, update anything?
Yeah, like, if it ain't broke, don't fix it.
Okay, I suppose this is the point.
I think they have done a little bit to it, but
I mean,
there's certain like categories and stuff that they got rid of.
I think they do like a fairly decent like apartment, like you can do apartments and everything on there. They've done a little bit better like maps and like you can zoom in and see where apartments are at. So that's how I found like a lot of my old apartments and roommates.
Really?
It used to be completely free too. You could post anything for free.
Exactly.
Now you pay for some things.
Yeah. Say, as long as you're willing to wade through the weirdos, you'll be fine.
Yeah, I've heard some weird stories of Craigslist.
Yeah.
My old boss's wife like cheated on him on Craigslist. I'm like, what the? Like, who uses Craigslist for that?
Oh my god.
And that one like movie or documentary, The Craigslist Killer or whatever.
I don't know about that.
Like, that, I learned about that when I was like 12, and I think it is. Craigslist after watching that movie.
Yeah.
But
always be a well-lit place with like a Starbucks whenever I'm doing any transactions.
Yes. Use your hands and just brush downwards pretty much,
yeah.
And that can help drain your neck, and then pulsing in here with your fingers to help stimulate these lymph nodes
really
can help too.
Okay.
Yeah, but that's something you can do to try to help, and then like around the ears, put your fingers like a V shape, and then the ear in between, and then just do like circles like that.
Really?
And like hold that. That can really help drain everything. Feeling like it's stuck in there. Does it feel like your ear kind of is clogged?
Yeah.
Just kind of got to get it moving.
Yeah, it's like I felt that way for a year now. Yeah, it's been I went to like an ENT and like there's nothing like blocking. There's no like nothing that's showing that there's actually any
like
big medical issues,
gotcha.
So then just like it's like the tense muscles or like your clenching or just the balance over there. So it's just frustrating. It's been that way forever. So I feel like I feel my balance for sure. Like just my right side is messed up.
Yeah. Just need some extra love.
Like straws, right? Like spaghetti straws.
Okay.
Straws.
Yeah.
And the the stuff, fluid flows through them like a straw, you know?
Yeah.
So you want the fluid to be really thin and flow really quick. What happens to the lymph is it gets thick.
Yeah.
Like
cottage cheese.
It clogs, it drains.
So doing like light movement and everything is a way to loosen it up, break it down a little bit, so you can get out of there.
Yeah, just stimulating it. And like I said, the lymph is gentle touch, like kind of like what I'm doing right now. It's not deep.
Yeah.
It's like very surface level. I like to kind of mix up and do different steps because obviously like having the tight muscles isn't going to let the lymph flow very well either.
Yeah.
So it's like, just adjust all of it.
Yeah, I'm like, it's always heavy handed whenever I'm doing like base or like muscles. It's like, okay, like I gotta work the muscle, but I'm doing the soft motion as well as actually used to.
Yes. And also, sometimes I can be like, this is not doing shit.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, you're sleeping.
Lymph legs gentle.
Yeah, it only takes about 5 minutes. So you're sleeping through the new sleep cycles?
Yes, exactly. It's another calming.
What's that?
We all need more calming stuff in our lives.
Everyone's out for breaking down.
For real?
Yeah,
so we have to be intentional with it.
You have to get
more
like 4 or 5 hours a day or less. Twice a day, and trying to go to work and everything else, food prep.
The tuning fork.
Do you have a lot of time to like, do you have like a big meal that you take to go to sleep?
No,
are you just not sleeping through the night or?
Because it's literally sending vibrations.
As soon as I get off work, I'll sleep for a few hours and then I go train.
Your body.
Yeah.
By the time I get home,
so that's really helping a bit too. It's stimulating that.
And then I'll try to put all my meals together.
That's why I have to just go to sleep.
Yeah, so the tuning forks are all different. This one is actually the same frequency the earth itself gives off.
So we use
our
dark cherry juice. Dark cherry juice.
Mm-hmm.
And,
I don't know if you know about grounding.
It's helping you sleep through the night.
I
take 4 tablespoons of it to a bed.
Yeah,
and
so our bodies have electricity in them, like we're electric.
I'll send you the link for the good. There's a lot. There's some that's really watered down. There's some that's way too thick.
So
I found
this
brand that you can just.
Your skin, especially your feet, can help. It has like
really
an antioxidant effect.
Well, and just drink a glass
of
it.
One of the most like powerfully healing things you can do, and it's so simple and it's pretty
yeah.
Cheap.
Yeah.
But yeah, those grounding mats pretty much just plug into the grounding port of the electric outlet, and then. So when you're connected to it, it's doing the same thing as if you were to connect directly with the earth. It's helping like pull out, because we're exposed to so much unnatural electricity, non-native EMFs and everything. So our body will like absorb that and hold on to it, and it can wreak havoc on a lot of the systems in the body. So.
Very cool.
Yes.
Yeah, I've got like a grounding strap for like electric work.
You have a grounding strap that you can wear like on your wrist?
Yeah.
Cool.
So you do it for like when you're working with like Delica electronics, you need to like ground yourself so you don't have static electricity, because like if you touch like a circuit board and you've got a lot of static electricity, it'll fry it completely.
Wow.
So if you don't need to ground yourself whenever you're working with those sorts of things.
That makes a lot of sense.
So I will pop that baby out and I'll throw it on my wrist.
Yeah, why not? Our grounding mat came with some wristbands you can wear too. But I haven't used them, I just used the mat. I don't know if it even works in here though, because this space is kind of old, so I don't know if the grounding port is even like. Effective,
yeah.
Working, so.
I would hope so. I mean, that's most of the time those things are just like copper wire directly to the metal, and that's usually connected directly to the metal.
So oh, okay.
It should work. Dangerous if it wasn't.
Yeah, I don't know. Really? Because I know some, like, when I was selling life insurance, I went to a guy's house and his outlets didn't even have the grounding cord.